Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar, and I'm coming to you from Colorado. And I wanted to talk to you a few minutes because it really matters. You know, I got a little bit of hot under the collar about this United Airlines incident because I want you to think about this for a minute. Now, in 9/11, we had that horrible situation where men from Saudi Arabia, boarded planes and crashed them into buildings and killed a lot of people. Now, because of that, we ended up with a whole different situation. Before that, you know, planes were a kind of a luxury. We were treated really well, and people really went out of their way to really give us a great experience. Now, I still see that sometimes, but I think that that has changed a lot. But it's really not about United as much as it is about how you treat yourself, how you expect to be treated, is usually how you will be treated. And it also is going to reflect on how you treat others. Now, when you're in business, that is so very important. If you don't treat your customers like they're made out of gold, they'll take their dollars somewhere else. And I made a comment to that effect on a post today that we can vote with our dollars. We are not required to do anything like what happened in the United story. For one thing, one guy said, "Oh, that's the law." Well, no, it is not the law. It is a rule that United made up. But let's just talk about one policy, not just even that one, but one other policy that they use to make sure their flights are not half full. They overbook. And when they overbook, they generally bump people out of their flights and make them take another flight, and often make them wait a long time in the airport before they get to be on a different flight. Now, if you've ever had that happen, or if you've ever had like a plane breakdown, I've had that happen more than once actually, and you sit in the airport, you're tired, you're cranky, you have none of your own things with you because you have, you know, you're sitting in a crowded place, or maybe you don't even get to sit down, and you have to wait for hours. Well, that's what this man did not want to do, and he had somewhere he wanted to go, and United didn't treat him well. They had a security officer actually come in and physically drag him off the plane. That caused him to have a broken nose and a concussion. Later, after United realized this was really causing a big flack, and a lot of people were pretty upset about it, they actually settled with all of the passengers of that flight. Now, United doesn't do that unless they actually know that they were wrong. They were wrong. Employees don't come before customers, and if that's their rule, I vote my dollars not to go to that airline ever again. So, you know, it's really about how you want to be treated. Do you want to condone what they did and say, "That's just the way it is, and I have to live with it"? Or do you want to start saying, "No, that isn't okay. I want you to treat me better, and I want you to make me number one, because after all, I'm the one that paid for that seat." And they're not cheap, are they? So if they're going to charge for those seats, then the customer needs to come first. The same thing as we in business, we are paying for whatever it is that we are as a customer, and the customer is paying for my time, my energy, my product. And if I want them to continue to buy my energy, my product, and pay me for what they perceived as the value that I'm offering them, then it's my responsibility to give them the best possible experience possible. If I don't do that, I have no right to expect that customer to stay. And that is exactly what has happened here. Now, United has such a huge amount of customer base that they don't think it's going to hurt them. But here's the problem. Social media is the biggest advertising agency in the world, and people push, you know, stuff around on the internet faster than any advertising agency ever could do in the past. So if you have done something that doesn't make you look good, it's a very, very good idea that you apologize very quickly and you find a way to make that customer happy. Because once you've lost that customer almost always has to go tell a lot of people that he is not happy. And the fact that this person got injured, regardless of whether it was okay for him to fight getting taken off the plane, that's not the issue. The issue is they treated him badly, and it will never be forgotten by any of us that that happened. There is no compensation that makes up for treating your customers badly. And once you've done it, no apology ever makes up for it. So isn't it a better idea to treat your customers really good at the beginning, before? So if you do make a tiny mistake and they hear your apology and they see that you really care, they're more likely to forgive. But if you treat your customers badly and you just treat them like they don't matter, I can promise you, you won't stay in business long. And I already know that United actually lost some stock from that process. This isn't the first time that they've done that. They broke a guitar. Just go and Google, United broke my guitar, because he did a song about it. And so this is what I want you to understand. You only have one chance to make a good impression on your customers. And when you do make a good impression on your customers, make sure that you treat them like they're made out of gold. Because one unhappy customer can ruin your business. And that's majorly the most important lesson that you should get from what I had to say today. I hope that helps. And make sure to get on our training. I'll put the link underneath this video. And you have a most awesome evening. And I'll be talking with you again probably tomorrow. Bye for now.